Blessed is our God, always, now, and forever, to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Glory to you, our God, glory to you. Our heavenly King, comforter, the Spirit of truth, who are present and present everywhere, filling all things, the treasury of good things and giver of life, come and abide in us. Cleanse us of every stain and save our souls, a good one.
Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and through the ages of ages. Amen. All Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. Lord, pardon our sins. Master, forgive our transgressions. Holy one, visit and heal our burdens for your name's sake. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and through the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
That is the kingdom and the power and glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now forever and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy, 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 Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and through the ages of ages. Amen. Come, let us worship and fall down before God, our King. Come, let us worship and fall down before Christ, our King and God. Come, let us worship and fall down before him, Christ, our King and our God.
Have mercy on me, O God, according to your great mercy, and according to the multitude of your compassion, blot out my transgression. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity and cleanse me from my sin. For I acknowledge my iniquity, and my sin is continually before me. Against you only have I sinned and done this evil before you, that you might be justified in your words and prevail when you are judged. For behold, I was conceived in iniquities, and in sins did my mother bear me. For behold, you have loved truth, the hidden and secret things of your wisdom you have made clear to me. You shall sprinkle me with hyssop, and I shall be made clean. You shall wash me, and I shall be made whiter than snow. You shall make me to hear joy and gladness. The bones which have been humbled shall rejoice. Turn your face away from my sins, and blot out all my iniquities. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from your presence, and take not your Holy Spirit from me. Restore to me the joy of your salvation, and with your governing spirit establish me. I shall teach transgressors your ways, and they shall turn back to you. Deliver me from blood guiltiness, O God of my salvation. My tongue shall rejoice in your righteousness. O Lord, you shall open my lips, and my mouth shall declare your praise. For if you had desired sacrifice, I would have given it with whole burnt offerings. You shall not be pleased. A sacrifice to God is a broken spirit. A heart that is broken and humbled, God will not despise. Do good to Zion in your good pleasure, O Lord, and let the walls of Jerusalem be built. Then shall you be pleased with the sacrifice of righteousness and with oblation and whole burnt offerings. Then shall they offer bullocks upon your altar.
O God, attend and help me, O Lord, make haste to help me. Let them that seek my soul be shamed and humiliated. Let them turn back and be ashamed that wish me evil. Let them turn back immediately and shame that say to me, hurrah, hurrah. Let all that seek you, God, exalt and be glad because of you. And let them that love your salvation say continually, the Lord be magnified. For I am any laborer, O God, help me. You are my helper, my deliverer, O Lord, do not delay. O Lord, hear my prayer. Give ear to my supplication in your truth. Hear me in your righteousness, and enter not into judgment with your servant, for before you no one living will be justified. The enemy pursued my soul. He lowered my life to the ground. He set me in darkness that day upon day. My spirit became despondent within me. My heart was agitated within me. I remember the day of old and meditated on all your deeds. I pondered the works of your hand. I was stretched. Spread out my arms to you. My soul thirsts for you like parched land. Quickly hear me, O Lord. My spirit has become faint. Turn not your face away from me, lest I become like those who go down into the pit. Let me hear of your mercy in the morning, for I have hoped in you. Show me, Lord, the way in which I should walk, for I have lifted up my soul to you. Rescue me from my enemies, O Lord. To you have I fled for refuge. Teach me to do your will, for you are my God. Your good spirit shall guide me on level ground. You will quit me, O Lord, for your name's sake. In your righteousness you will bring my soul out of affliction, and in your mercy you will exterminate my enemy, and you will destroy all those who afflict my soul, for I am your servant.
Glory in the highest to God, his peace is on earth, his good pleasure in mankind. We praise you, we bless you, we worship you, we glorify you, we give thanks to you for your great glory. Lord King, heavenly God, Father, ruler over all, Lord, only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, and you, O Holy Spirit, Lord God, Lamb of God, O Son of the Father, take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You that take away the sins of the world, accept our supplication. You that sit at the right hand of the Father, and have mercy on us. For you alone are holy, you alone are Lord, Jesus Christ, to the glory of God the Father. Amen. Every day I will bless you, and your name will I praise to eternity and forever and ever. Lord, you have given our refuge from generation to generation. I said, Lord, have mercy on me. Heal my soul, for I have sinned against you. Lord, I have fled to you. Teach me to do your will, for you are my God. For with you is the fountain of life, and in your light we shall see your light. Continue your mercy to those who know you. Vouchsafe, O Lord, that on this night that we be kept without sin. Blessed are you, O Lord, the God of our fathers. Your name is praised and glorified unto the ages. Amen. Let your mercy be on us, O Lord, as we have set our hope in you. Blessed are you, O Lord, teach me your statutes. Blessed are you, O Master, give me to understand your statutes. Blessed are you, O Holy One, enlighten me with your statutes. O Lord, your mercy is forever. Despise not the works of your hands. To you is due praise, to you is due song, to you is due glory, to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen.
I believe in one God, Father,
ruler of all, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible. And in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father before all ages, light of light, true God, and true God, begotten, not made, co-essential with the Father, and through whom all things were made, who for us did and for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnated by the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became man, and was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate, and suffered and was buried, and resurrected on the third day according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father, and shall come glory to judge the living and the dead, and whose reign shall have no end. And in the Holy Spirit, to the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father, who together with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets.
In one holy church, in the apostolic church, as for baptism for the remission of sins, I await the resurrection of the dead and the life of the age to come. Amen. It is truly me to call you blessed, O Theotokos, the ever-blessed, the ever-blessed, and the mother of our God, greater in honor than the cherubim, and in greater beyond compare than the seraphim. You, without corruption, gave birth to God the Word, and are truly, Theotokos, you do we magnify.
Anixotos nomam mukepiro, iset epnevmatos, ke logon erexomen, vasilivimitri, ke ofisomen, Pedros pani irizon, ke aso ikomen ostafis ta tavmata. Rejoice you the only one. of the King of all, the aromatic also. Rejoice, O unwedded, may the world deliver.
Thank you.
Sestitasim vana epititia doxisu sigara piroga me partene esce semitra ton epipandum theon che te toca sacronion pacitissimus isesu diria travevo da
beyond the final chamber of the word, for
The darkness of our error now
the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Deceased have been quickened through your power, for pregnant were you with life hypostasized. They who were once speechless now speak with newfound eloquence. Diseases are exterminated, lepers purified, the legions of the aerial spirits, O Virgin, are defeated, for you are man's salvation.
Thank you.
Rejoice, O flower of incorruptness. Rejoice, O crown of laurel for continents. Rejoice, for in you resurrection is typified. Rejoice, for angelical life you exemplify. Rejoice, fertile tree with luscious fruit by which believers are sustained. Rejoice, foliage tree beneath which are many sheltered in its shade. Rejoice, for you were pregnant with the guide for the errant. Rejoice, for of the freer of captives you are the parent. Rejoice, who plead till the just judge surrenders. Rejoice, forgiveness for many offenders. Rejoice, the vesture of those stripped of confidence. Rejoice, the tender love that conquers every longing. Rejoice, O unwedded bride.
Rich.
which the elephant renders, we see speechless as fishes. For when they contemplate you, O Theotokos, for at a loss are they to explain how you manage childbirth and a virgin yet remain. But we, in marveling at the mystery, cry out with conviction, rejoice, God's wisdom's repository, rejoice, his providence's depository. Rejoice who prove the philosopher's wisdomless. Rejoice who reprove the sophist as ridiculous. Rejoice for the debaters, fierce debaters, becoming fools, lost their taste. Rejoice for the creators of the myths have faded away. Rejoice who rend the webs of the Athenians. Rejoice you who fill the nets of the fishermen. Rejoice who drag out from the deep of ignorance. Rejoice who illuminate many with cognizance. Rejoice the barge for those seeking salvation. Rejoice the harbor for life's navigators. Rejoice, O unwedded bride. Set all things in order, came down to it of his own volition. And though being the shepherd as God, for us he appeared like us as a man, and having called his own life by life, as God he hears, Alleluia.
Martyr saints as being nature's first fruits at their earnest entreaty, he church in your steadfast and boundless peace, through the Theotokos, the Lord, abundantly merciful. O Christ God, who at every time and hour, in heaven and on earth, are worshipped and glorified, the long-suffering, very merciful, very compassionate Lord, who loved the righteous and had mercy on sinners, we call all to each salvation through the promise of good things to come. You also accept our prayers of desire and direct our life in the way of your commandment. Sanctify our souls, purify our bodies, correct our thoughts, cleanse our conceptual images, and deliver us from every tribulation, evil, and distress. Surround us with your holy angels, so that guarded and guided in their camp, we may reach the unity of the faith and the knowledge of your unapproachable glory. For you, O blessed, to the ages of ages. Amen. Christ God, who at every time and hour in heaven and on earth are worshipped and glorified, long-suffering, very merciful, very compassionate Lord, who love the righteous and have mercy on sinners, we call all to salvation through the promise of good things to come. You also accept our prayers of desire and direct our life in the way of your commandments. Sanctify our souls, purify our bodies, correct our thoughts, cleanse our conceptual images, and deliver us from every tribulation, evil, and distress. Surround us with your holy angels, so that guarded and guided in their camps, we may reach the end of faith and the knowledge of your unapproachable glory. For you are blessed to the ages of ages. Amen.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and forever, to the ages of ages. Amen. Greater in honor than the cherubim, and glory greater beyond the pair than the seraphim. That corruption gave birth to God the lowest, Lord, that they are both as you be united with. May God be gracious unto us and bless us, may cause his face to shine upon us and have mercy upon us. Thank you.
Unidas por San Francisco, la Misión, en Alfa Censora, los Cristianos, que día filo, son y más por el profesor Filú, y Brutista Martínez, que hago pases con el Ministerio de Trinity y Patria, más en la Sumación Japón, tres en la Pepina Mena, Beli, su Conibú, la Casa Pimón, Julios, y Nomenón, la Casa Cosimón, en Panamastasis, Catástilón, el Juan de Oles, el Conimón, Crónima, Comisín, Kimisín, son, el Ori, el Emilio, de otro, Rigorón, un
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Bright center.
I have no clue how they measured it, but they measured one part of that center, from one end of that little bright center to the other. They measured it. They measured it 30,000 light years. 30,000 light years. You know what a light year is? You know how fast light travels? 186,000 miles every second. Light travels 186,000 miles every second. That's how fast light travels. Going at that speed from one end of our galaxy, just not even the fullness of the galaxy, just the center, from one end of that center to the other end of that center, it takes light going at that speed 30,000 years to go from one end to the other. That's just one little part of one little bit of one galaxy in the known universe. And there are thousands of galaxies in the known universe. The God that made that spoke, and it came into order. That's what our God did. He spoke, and it came into order. Just came into order. The angels witnessed this. What could possibly amaze an angel after seeing that? I mean, what could possibly amaze an angel? They have seen everything. They've witnessed the world being created, God destroying it through a flood, and recreating it again. They've witnessed the most beautiful paradise. They witnessed two people being placed in it, given one rule and not even following it. What amazes an angel? Today we celebrate, not tomorrow, Quadratus that we talked about. Today we celebrate the 40 martyrs of Sebastopol. You know this story, right? On the 9th of March, the 40 martyrs of Sebastopol, 40 men that would not turn their back on their Lord, to the point where the ruler of the area said, "Do it or you're going to die." We've heard stories like that before, but we've not heard stories like this. To torture them, he stripped them naked and in the freezing cold made them go and walk naked into a lake and stand there all night. Forty of them. What were they doing in the middle of the lake? Praising God as they were dying. Angels have seen it all. They've even seen one of those 40 martyrs give up. They saw it. They saw one of those 40 martyrs give up, left his 39 brethren, said, "Forget it. This Jesus isn't worth it." They've seen it all. But we still commemorate 40 martyrs. So what happened? One of the soldiers that was killing them, that was overseeing their execution, saw their faith and said, "Whatever they have, whatever their God is doing, I want it." Stripped himself down and joined them. And was martyred and crowned with them. Angels have seen it all. What amazes them? What does the church tell us that the angels are amazed by? This. The fact that our God, whom they worshiped, takes on flesh. They were dumbfounded. They couldn't understand it. They couldn't believe it. with such amazement. And then even more so was Gabriel when he saw the woman that was chosen to do this. Just so simple. So pure. So right. So fitting. Axiom, so worthy. Right? Axiomistic. So worthy. We say meet, we say it's right. But axio means to be worthy. The small little bit continues. It says, for once the inaccessible God, God that we know in his fullness, we don't know, we'll never know him in his fullness. He will never be fully 100% accessible to us in his fullness form. Except in the way that he has made himself accessible to all of us in the person of Jesus Christ. And thus hearing from everyone the words, Alleluia. Again, very appropriate that they would hear Alleluia, because as I've said and as the church fathers have told us, whenever we say Alleluia, God's there. Small little thing. The angels were amazed. So what? We gloss over. We don't even think about it. Of course they're amazed. What else would they be? But we forget what they've seen. We forget what angels have experienced. We forget what they have experienced, seen, participated in, helped accomplish, been messengers of. They've seen everything. They've seen things that we can't even possibly contemplate. And with all of that, what are they amazed by? Her. She amazes them. They're amazed by what she accomplished with the Lord's help. We only have one more Friday left to hear the beginning. We'll hear the fourth stanza next week in Weirton at 7 o'clock, not at 6 o'clock. If you come at 6 o'clock, you'll be very, very early, which is fine. It's good. Good to be early. I like being a little late to everything. 7 next week in Weirton. And then the following Friday, back here, 6 o'clock, where we will have the visit of the Guardia Visa. May God bless you, may he keep you, and may we continue to be amazed as the angels were whenever we look.